Shalom. Today we are continuing to unravel the various paradigms for Hebrew verbs. We're still working in the participle. Remember, the participle is equivalent to the present tense, and it can mean any one of these things. I do, I am doing, I have been doing, or I am the one that does. We have already covered the pa'al, the pl, and the hifil. Today we're going on to the pu'al and the hophal, and you see that these two new verbs today, these two new binyanim, will also be ones where the participle starts with mem. Remember, the participle has four forms: a masculine singular, a feminine singular, a masculine plural, and a feminine plural. The two forms that we're doing today are passive. These are the first passive forms that we're covering. So just to review, what does it mean that a verb is passive? In the active form, we see that the subject of the sentence is doing the action. I write a letter, I wrote a letter, I will write a letter. Active and passive have nothing to do with the tense of the verb. The active can appear in all three tenses and the passive. In the passive form, the subject of the sentence receives the action of the verb. The letter is written by me. The letter's not doing anything. The letter receives the action of the writing. In the past, the letter was written by me. In the future tense, the letter will be written by me. And then we have the reflexive, which we will get to another time. So we will start with the pu'al, which is variously spelled these ways. The pu'al usually corresponds to the pl form. The pu'al is usually the passive of the pl form, but not always. So returning to this root, lamed mem dalet, we have it in the pa'al in the simple form, lomed, lomedet, lomdim, lomdot. That means learning. I learn, he learns, you learn. In the pl form, remember the pl form participles begin with mem. So then we have milamed, milamedet, milamdim, milamdot, and that means to teach. I teach, you teach, we teach. The paradigm for the participle pu'al looks like this. They begin with mem. The u sound appears under the first letter of the root, milumad. In other words, he is someone that is taught. In the PL, the person is teaching. The person is doing the action. In the pu'al, the person receives the action. He is taught. The modern feminine form is milumedet, but we will see that it's a recognizable feminine form in Tanakh, milumada, and milumadim, milumadot. So we can recognize these forms. The mem gives us the participle form, the u tells us that it's a passive form, but it has the normal endings on it. So, from Tanakh, from Hosea 10:11, Ephraim egla melumada. Ephraim is a calf who has been taught, who is being taught. Egel is a calf. Here it's a feminine form, and so it takes a feminine verb, melumada. In Song of Songs 3:8, we see talking about some warriors. Kulam achuzei cherev milumdei milchama. It is a bit more difficult to find examples of these forms, so we don't have a straight masculine singular. This is the masculine plural, but it appears in the smichut form, the construct form. So I hope you know what that is. So all of them, Achuzei, they are holding a sword. Milumdei milchama, they are taught, they are being taught in the art of war. Here is a word that you might recognize, which comes directly from Hebrew in this form into Yiddish and then into popular English. V'hayita mishuga mimar'e enecha asher tir'eh. shaga means to go astray. Actually, it's mostly used in this pu'al form, and it means crazy. Moses is talking about what the people will see in the future. And because of the breakdown of society, the breakdown of Torah, then the people will be crazy when they see the things that they see with their eyes for the lack of Torah. Here's a plural form in 1 Samuel 21, Chaser Meshuga Imani. This is when David goes and feigns madness so he can escape from Gat. And the king says, Chasar Meshugaim Ani. Am I lacking in crazy people that you brought David here to be crazy? Take him away. If you look at the end of the first line, you see the verb lehishtageya. And so this is also the same root, but it's in a hitpa'el form. We'll study that later. Another verse that you know from Isaiah 53:4, and it talks about a prophecy of Messiah, how he bears our weaknesses and suffers our sicknesses. And we thought him smitten of God, u me'une. So the root here is ayin nun hey, and which means to afflict, and we see that he is afflicted. He is receiving the action. He's not afflicting anybody. He is receiving the action. This verb, this root does end in hey, and as we saw with other verbs in the participle form that end in hey, you have a segol under the middle letter. As I said earlier, there are just not that many examples of pu'al and hophal in Tanakh. For comparison, if you're looking for a pa'al participle, according to accounts in the parsing section of the Blue Letter Bible, there are over 5,000 examples. The pu'al participle has 700 examples. Hifil has 800 examples. So we're able to go over all the regular irregularities, what are called the weak verbs, and we had more examples. But for the pu'al, there's only 194 examples, and the hophal only has 113. So we're just a bit limited in what we can show. Another passive binyan is the hophal or hufal, variously spelled in all these ways, because different vowels do appear in the actual forms. Generally, the hophal is the passive form of the hifil, but not always. We're going to look at this root, shalach, shin, lamed, kaf. We have previously looked at shin, lamed, chet, which means to send. Shalach in this, with the kaf, is a bit stronger in the idea of casting out or throwing something out. So in this hophal form, you're going to see the u sound come under the mem. Remember, in the pu'al form, the u sound comes after the first letter of the root. In the hophal form, the u sound comes under the mem. Mushlach, mushlechet, mushlachim, mushlachot. All recognizable forms. In 2 Samuel 20, something of a peculiar story is going on here. Sheva ben Bichri has started a bit of a rebellion against David, and David sends Yoav off to capture him. And he comes to the town where Sheva is hiding out, and a woman comes out and she makes a negotiation. She says, look, we don't want any trouble. We're just going to kill him and throw his head over the wall, and then you'll know that he's dead. And so we see this in the last part of the verse, V'tomar ha'isha el Yoav. And the woman says to Yoav, Hine rosho mushlach elecha ba'ad hachoma. Behold, his head is being cast, it's being thrown. The head's not doing anything, it's receiving the action, it's a passive form. And so they cut his head off and throw it over the wall. In 1 Kings 13:24, another interesting story, which I think must be prophetic, but I I don't know how it works out, but the man of God was told not to stop on his way, but he was beguiled by another so-called prophet who invited him in to eat, and so God sends a lion to kill the first prophet. And so that's what happens, and the lion finds him on the road, vaimitehu, and kills him. Vatehi nivlato mushlechet baderech. And it happened, nivlato, nivela is a corpse, his corpse, mushlechet, is being thrown. Not being thrown in a far direction, but being maybe cast down to the ground, baderech, on the road. If you have any clues about what this might be portending, I would certainly love to hear from you. If we have a hollow verb, which we have done bo in some other binyans, we see that the u sound still comes with the mem, and as in other hollow participle verbs, we do not see the vav at all. Muva, muvet, which we would expect the ending for a participle ending in aleph, that we would get a tsere and then a tav. Muva'im and muva'ot, these are recognizable forms. Talking about the money which is brought to the house of Yehovah. Et ha-kesef ha-muva. The money's not doing anything. The money is being brought into the house of the Lord. In Genesis 43:18, speaking of the brothers, when they are in Egypt, and they are quite nervous because they're not sure why they are being brought to meet with Joseph, to eat with Joseph, and they've had all this incidents with the money being found in their sacks and so on, and they say, Anachnu muva'im lehitgolel alenu. U lehitnapel alenu. So they say, we are being brought, muva'im. They're not doing anything. Someone else is bringing them to Joseph's house. What for? Lehit galel alenu, to reveal something. Maybe there's going to be an interrogation. And then lehit napel alenu, to fall upon us. They are some nervous guys. Here in a plural feminine form from Psalm 45 is talking about the wedding of the king. And here's the bride and her girlfriends are being brought also. Re'oteha, her girlfriends, muva'ot, they are being brought, lach, apparently to the king. When we have a verb that begins in yud, coming into the hophal, we lose the yud altogether. This is true for any drop letter imperfect. So yatsa, yatse in the pa'al means to go out. Lahotzi, we discovered in Hethiel, means to bring out. And here this form, mutza, means they are brought out, or singular, he is brought out. Again, the feminine, because it ends in aleph, we see the tseri under the tzadi and the tav. Mutzaim, mutzaot, no yud. Genesis 38, Tamar has accomplished this ruse against Judah. Now people know that she's pregnant, and she is being brought out. He mutzet. She's being brought out of the father's tent to be examined. And what does she come with? She says, oh, whoever's a passport and driver's license and ID card this man is the father. She was a crafty lady. In Ezekiel 14, talking about those which the remnant which has escaped, and they are being brought out, sons and daughters. The mutzaim, this is in a positive, sons and daughters. Behold, they are coming out. The ones who are being brought out, they are coming out. Finally, in a feminine plural form, in Jeremiah 38, speaking of kol hanashim, all the women which are left in the house of the king of Judah, mutzaot, they are being brought out to the princes of the king of Babel. I hope this is somewhat helpful. for you to get a handle on these different forms. Next time we'll go on to a different binyan. In the meantime, tasimata inayim al hashamayim. Keep your eye on the sky. Your redemption draweth nigh. Shalom.